What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel.
Earn it, save it, invest it.
Where I talk about the stock market, personal finances, and basically anything money. Today, I'm going to be talking about my top five pros and cons on making money charging electric scooters. Let's go. My first pro is having no boss. You don't have anyone to answer to. You don't have any management. You don't have anyone telling you to clock in. You don't have anyone telling you do this, do that. You know, you can't take a break, and you know, there's really no one telling you to do anything. It's up to you, and it's really nice to be your own boss. So that's definitely my number one pro. My number two pro is side hustle. It's really nice to have more options out there besides the Uber and Lyft and the other things, the Uber Eats and all that stuff, where you have more options to do a side hustle, where I can get off work or before I go into work, you can do a little bit of extra work to make a little bit of extra money without having to put in a lot of dedication. Number three pro is it's easy. It's really easy to do. Almost anybody can do it. I can do it. My wife can do it. Kids can do it. You know, it's an easy job to do. So, you know, you go on the app, you look up the birds or the limes, whatever, the electric scooter, you find it, you bring it home, you charge it, you put it back out. It's very easy to do. My number four pro is flexible. It's very flexible. If you have a full-time job, guess what? This basically can work around that job almost guaranteed. So unless you're basically working graveyard shift at some point between 4 and 7 a.m., you can't do this. But besides that, this is a very flexible job. You go when you want. I can go right now, go on the app, and look it up. If I don't want to, I don't have to. My number five pro is money. There's a lot of people out there looking for other ways to make extra money, and this is another way to make extra money. My favorite personal story of mine is I was going to a Pollo Loco after work, and I wasn't trying to pick up birds. I wasn't doing any of that. Right before I walked in, I saw a bird that was laying against the wall, and someone had ripped off the GPS or done something like that. And so I said, hey, you know, maybe I'll go on the app and see if it's worth anything. It was worth 20 bucks. I just threw it in my car, put it out the next day, and there we go. I got three free meals, basically, at El Pollo Loco. Now, you can go around on your daily life, just have the app downloaded, and if you see a broken bird, you can most likely take that, and it'll be worth like 10, 15, 20 bucks. So you don't even really have to work it, but if you're someone who's willing to take one once in a while, then it could just be free money lying around. Let's say you did it once a week for 20 bucks, that's $80 a month. For, you know, simply just doing and going about your business. All right, so I gave you the good news first, bad news last. So now let's move on to my top five cons on charging electric scooters. My number one con is self-motivation. Just like my number one pro is no boss, well then that also requires you to have self-motivation. No one's gonna tell you to do anything. No one's gonna kick you up off the couch. No one's gonna tell you to do anything, basically, so you have to do it yourself. It's not just something where it's like, oh, hey, it's easy money, I just walk in and pick up a check, pick up some money. No, you actually have to do it. You have to want to do it. You have to go out there yourself and put yourself out there. So that would be, I guess, a con. Doesn't mean it's for everyone, but it does mean that in order to have no boss, you have to have more self-motivation. My number two con is no guarantees. When you're out there looking for these scooters, there's no guarantee that you'll actually find a scooter. If it's on the map could be delayed. You might not be able to find it. It might be in someone's yard, whatever the case may be. There's no guarantees. And that also goes with my number two pro, side hustle. A lot of side hustles, there's no guarantees. Now you can make money, you can do it in different ways, but really there's no guarantee. And that also goes with having no boss. When there's no boss and you have to be self-motivation, only you yourself can really guarantee what you do and what you can put out there. My number three con is it requires equipment. It doesn't take much. It takes a driver's license, a car, or a truck. It takes you to have a phone with service, and it takes you to have a place to charge them, and obviously the chargers that they'll send to you. It's not a whole lot of equipment. It's not very much. It's not more than what the average person has, but essentially if you wanted to work at McDonald's, you could live on the street, take a bus, or live a block away, whatever, walk in with the uniform they provide for you, get the paycheck, and walk away and live on the street. You could basically essentially do that with no equipment, have a part-time, full-time, minimum wage job. With this, even though it's a side hustle and there's no guarantees or anything, it also requires equipment. It's not a lot of equipment, it's not more than the average person should be able to provide, but it does require some equipment. Oh. Well, it's 4 in the morning. That's right. 4 a.m. to 7 a.m. drop off. That is probably the biggest con of all, is that you have to wake up early. If you're not a morning person, if you're not a late night, I guess into the next morning type of person, it's going to be hard for you to wake up. Now, I guess waking up at 6 isn't too much of a hassle, but I will say the drop-off locations that you are that are available will get taken from 4 to 5 to 6. So as you get closer to that 7 a.m. spot, there'll be a lot less places you can drop them off. So essentially, you don't have to wake up at 4, but you want to be waking up fairly on the early side, and that is the only time to get paid. If you do not drop them off, if you capture an electric scooter, the next day you have to drop it off at a certain time or else they will deduct your pay. So that is one of the biggest cons, I guess, is having to wake up early and do that, but it only takes about 30 minutes or so to do it. And for my last con, I have competition. Competition's heating up, and it's good and bad, I guess, right? There'll be more electric scooters out there when it comes to competition in the business side. They'll be putting out more scooters out there, but because this is becoming more mainstream and people are seeing, wow, this is an easy way to make money, there's more chargers out there. There's more people charging the scooters. So when I was out there in my video, I had a guy, he was in the van, and it had like 20 had at least like 20 scooters in there, you know, from both Lime and Bird. And I've heard that Bird has lowered their base price down to 3 from 5. Where I live right now, Los Angeles, that's not the case. And I've had other people say that's not the case, but I've had a lot of people say that that's what's happening. I know Lime does charge a little different as well. I don't know exactly what's going to happen in the future, but I do know it is getting bigger. Therefore, there will be more competition out there. Thank you guys for watching my video on my top 5 pros and cons on charging electric scooters. It's up to you to decide if you even want to be a part of it. You can also just download the app and start going around your daily business. And if you see a broken scooter, look it up and boom, it might be worth some money. So again, it's all up to you. Thank you for watching. Go ahead and click the like and subscribe. And don't forget to
earn it, save it, invest it, buy low, sell high. I want assets, not liabilities, and you can count on compounded interest!